I mean, smash it and pretend it was an accident.
Because that would make me a terrible role model. But children are allowed to have that kind of accident.
So you're saying you want us to smash the vase?
A good mother would never ask such a thing. Don't you dare break this vase.
So you don't want us to smash the vase? What's the most surefire way of guaranteeing something will break? Put it in the mail, marked fragile.
Mailman, special delivery.
We're not here. Could you just, post it through the door?
Makes sense to me.
That's not the vase.
Yeah, that's the tablet Gumball asked Mom for his birthday.
There's this, too.
It's hopeless. It's indestructible. We just need to accept it. We're gonna be lumbered with this vase for the rest of our lives. Rest of our lives.
All set for your prom night, son?
Yeah.
There she is. Isn't she beautiful?
Okay, graduates, say synthetic organic cheese substitute.
I never thought I'd say this. But, Vase, you was the best gosh darn friend I ever had.
That wasn't my vision.
We've seriously got to get rid of this thing.
I'm amazed they haven't smashed it by now.
Well, actually, Mom told us to
look after it because it contains the ashes of a beloved pet, and we're sad to see it go, but if that's how it's got to be, then bye!
I thought that might be the case, so I've brought you this.
One's even nicer.
Personally, I think it's hideous, but I know you have very different tastes to me. That's the one I meant to give you all along. Anyway, I better get Roosevelt back to Louis. He just can't sleep without the dried-out remains of a cold-blooded reptile by his side.
You haven't been gone that long, have you?